I'm Patrick Boyle. I'm a finance professor at two of the top UK universities teaching the derivatives class to Masters in Finance students. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In today's video, we're going to learn about our second derivative, which is forwards. Take a look at my other videos to learn about other derivatives like futures, options, swaps, credit derivatives, and many more. I'm creating these videos from my book, Trading and Pricing Financial Derivatives, which is available for sale on Amazon. If you're really interested in this topic, it might be worth checking it out. I've provided a link in the description below if you want to look at it. Okay, so in today's video, we're going to learn what forwards are and how do they differ from futures, which we learned about in the last video. A forward contract is a non-standardized contract between two parties to buy or sell an asset at a specified future time at a price agreed upon today. As I mentioned in the last video, forwards are legal contracts between two counterparties. The party agreeing to buy the underlying asset in the future assumes a long position, and the party agreeing to sell the asset in the future assumes a short position. The price agreed upon is called the delivery price, which is equal to the forward price at the time the contract is entered into. Forwards are substantially similar to futures, with these important differences. 1. Forwards are private contracts and do not trade on organized exchanges. Futures contracts, on the other hand, do trade on organized exchanges. Number 2. Forwards are customized contracts satisfying the needs of the parties involved. Futures contracts are highly standardized. Number 3. Forwards are contracts with the originating counterparty. On the other hand, a single clearinghouse is the counterparty to all futures contracts. Forwards need not be associated with any clearinghouse. Number 4. Forward contracts are usually not regulated. The government regulates futures markets. Number 5. Forwards typically have no interim partial settlements or margin requirements like futures. However, because they are traded over the counter, forward contract specification can of course be customized and could possibly include mark-to-market and daily margining if required. Check out my other videos on financial derivatives to learn more. Coming up next, we're going to learn about how futures and forwards pay off, how margin works on futures, and how we calculate the fair value of a futures or a forward contract. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button below and tell your friends about it. If you hated the video, also click the like button and try to be a little bit more positive. Make sure you subscribe if you'd like to see more videos like this, and equally comment below if there's a topic that you'd really like me to cover. Anyhow, see you later. Bye.